How far you want me to go to pegs? A large claim, 100 metres?
I think it's a small one, man. Hey.
Go to the front section first, eh, cuz? Let's do it.
After finding Trace here last night, the Mooka Boys have decided to bulldoze a shallow open cut. But first, they need to peg the 50 by 50 metre claim they've just registered with the Mines Department, giving them exclusive rights to work the land.
Pretty hopeful for German gully cut today. It's pretty shallow ground. Back about 5 foot is about as deep as we're going to have to go, so we'll get a pretty quick look on it.
A lot of it's been done with dozer cuts, so there's a lot of dirt that's been pushed on top of virgin ground.
Hoping to find virgin opal dirt under old mine dumps, they're using Leif's 40-ton, 44-year-old bulldozer.
Dad and I built that dozer together. We bought it and fixed it up. We spent, you know, 30 or 40 grand. It's one of the last things we did together. So I'll take that dozer with me everywhere, literally.
Leif's just pushing all the top piles over at the moment, just trying to get to that virgin ground. We just got a narrow corridor between some other claims. We're just having a little look, hoping something pops up, but yeah, we're still a little way yet. Hopefully we've got enough diesel to finish the whole claim.
We really need to find some opal on this one. We've come unlucky everywhere else. This is the last little bit of diesel we have, so if we don't find the opal, it all comes out of our pockets.
Hey, Cozzy! There's an oil leak, man! Stop him!
Got some oil leaking out the back there.
Yeah, just straight out the back here, man. There's just an oil drip coming down the back.
It's coming from the steering clutch valve.
That doesn't sound good.
No, that's not.
Won't be able to steer if it goes in, eh?
Yeah. That's with a steering valve block, and that determines your clutches, which way the machine can move, so. Worst case scenario is that the machine drops all the oil and you can't move it.
Yeah, no, it just turned up a little bit of level in that deep spot, man. So we don't want to be blowing oil all over the place now.
Can you sort of do us a favour? Could you please grab us a 17 mil spanner?
17, yep, we got it.
In Andamooka, an oil leak in the Mooka Boys' 44-year-old dozer means the machine, essential for exposing opal, is out of action.
We're using pretty old machines, so they tend to blow seals here and there and leak a bit of oil. But if we don't get onto it properly now, it could be a catastrophic damage to the dozer for sure.
We can't afford to lose oil. A drum of oil is $1,000. So literally, yeah, every litre's $10, so to say.
I think we're in luck. Is this an O-ring?
Oh, thank God for that.
We've got an O-ring here, which is a rubber seal between the two flanges. It's got a little bit of life left in it, but it's quite flat. You see the difference in the new O-ring? One's flat, one's round. So that's the old one, that's the new one. So they'll close between two things like that seal. I'm hoping this is just a solution. Just if we change that, we should be good.
Let's kick her in the guts and get into this bloody opal level, eh? We find a lot of seam opal here, but finding a blobby is the dream, basically. A blobby is a big chunk of opal, like something that's a really big stone, it's unusual.
Blobbies form when opal fills an unusually large void. The biggest blobbies are up to 50 centimetres in diameter, but are very rare and can be worth hundreds of thousands of dollars.
Yeah, we're starting to find a bit of chunks with some opal trace in it. You can kind of see the little lines in there. Small lines of opal have been encapsulated in the rock around here, which is a really good sign for us because we're looking for big matrix and we're looking for big seams. So it's only trace, but it tells us at least there's opal here, so we've got a chance. We just got to hope we can find that bigger piece.
We're not looking too well if we don't find any opal out of here. We've used a fair bit of diesel and, we need to make something out of this, otherwise, I don't know what we'll be doing.
So let's move most of the piles. We're just starting to find the original surface before people put dirt on top. Starting to see that red dirt that's on top of everything, so, yep. We don't want to go any deeper than this for now.
And the Mooka is patchy ground, so you don't have runs. And a lot of those areas where they did have those big pockets already been taken.
Hey, Cozzy! Get over here!
Wow!
I was just checking a level back there. Look what I just found!
Yes!
Loving country!
Woo!
Holy crap! I just went to have a look at what the level might look like. Just took a bit out the wall and this big blobby fell out.
I can't hear anything, I have my earplugs in still.
Don't have to hear, bro, I've just opened your eyes. Look at it. I've come across a blobby, man. Sitting right there for us. That's some top quality Anamooka blobby matrix. That's what we're here for, boys. This is the biggest piece of Opal I've found in a long time.
That's beautiful, man.
Yeah, you know, we've had a really rough start to the season. Everything wasn't working out for us so far, but finding a bit of colour like this really, really gives you hope. What we're doing here is a treatment by using some sugar and some acid to basically carbonise the pores inside of the host rock, and it'll bring it out the colour much more vibrant.
In Andamooka, brothers Matt and Koza are chemically treating a chip from their large blobby opal.
What we do is we want to give it a bit of a rinse to get the sugar off the outside of it. We're really hoping this host rock darkens in the matrix and really brings out that colour. We're going to need every dollar we can this season. We've got the sulfuric acid up to heat now, just below simmering. We'll give it a bit of time, see if we have the reaction.
After adding the sulfuric acid, a chemical reaction begins with the sugar in the host rock. The acid converts the sugar's hydrogen and oxygen molecules into water, leaving the black carbon molecules embedded in the stone.
Now you reckon, Coz, it's time for a look?
Yeah, let's have a look. Hopefully it's got dark.
Yeah, it's definitely reacted with the sugar, giving us that carbon we're looking for. Big moment. Have a little rinse down here. That's it.
Oh, look at that.
Look at that.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, nice reds and blues and greens and yellows and oranges. Beautiful colours. I could not be happier with that. And this is only going to get better with more treatments too. So,
We only thought half of it had colour until we treated it, the whole lot. So glad you hit that rock yesterday, Matty.
I know. See, you can sort of see the comparison once we treat it to the natural stone. Once you darken that host rock, that colour can really stand out. And this is a perfect example of that. I'm ecstatic, man.
Yeah,
we did so
excellent.
Good.
The treated chip off the opal blobby displays the full colour spectrum across the face. The combined weight of the treated and untreated opal is 453 grams.
So, man, we got a bit of a test track. Yeah.
You beauty. Look at that. I can see this sort of stuff being $50, $60 a carat when it's cut, easy.
What do you reckon is a blob price?
Well, look, 16 ounces gets us 2,480 carats. I think we should be asking at least 10 bucks a carat. That's going to net us $24,800.
Mate, that's not a bad week at all.
We needed it.
Season's looking a lot more promising now. This week's turned out very good for us.
We've got the potential of finding a whole new field here as well, and, you know, we're not scared to go out there and bloody, you know, do it.